I got a little test for us today. We'll go to Glacier National Park. Glacier National Park was always on my bucket list to go with his magnificence and beauty National Park has to offer. We discussed with my wife and we decide to take a break.
We decided to take a break from busy Seattle life and take 10 days grand trip to see three biggest national parks, Glacier National Park, Yellowstone and Grant Teton. A few of those moments we're gonna share with you. Stay tuned.
We left Seattle and made our first stop in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, when we just spent overnight and hit road very early morning.
Now on the East Glacier, it's an amazing place.
Nice start of the day.
You like
enjoying
it?
Enjoying it a lot, yep.
Yeah.
We're right now in Glacier and we arrived yesterday to St. Mary Resort Campground. It's an amazing place on East Glacier. It has showers, swimming pool, everything you want. And next to you always beauty and wildlife. We love it.
Decided to take our first hike to St. Mary area waterfalls on going to the Sun Road.
It's so beautiful over here. Guys, check this out. That's a very dangerous hike. Grizzly country, guys. You guys can see, you know, here just flying away. Oh, that's where we're going to go today, guys. Here's my wife. Most beautiful wife in the whole world.
Just for you.
This view is unbeatable. Guys, this is a perfect example how you should not hike in a bear country, because if you keep your bear spray in a backpack, it's like no way you can get out fast. So you have to keep it in hands when you're hiking. And I'm gonna stop in right now.
Bear will not attack you. All right. Because he knows a lot of animals.
All right. Maybe that's a good argument. We'll see. Guys, you're not gonna believe how beautiful it is. Here, I wanna jump. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy. I've never been happy in my life like today. It's a beautiful hike. I like those reddish colors on the mountains. It's make like somebody actually painted and probably represent like thousands of years of the history of this glacier. It's so beautiful, guys. Seattle, we're approaching first waterfall, but this is not the main one. Other people told us, don't stop here, just keep going. And this is St. Mary Waterfalls Bridge to the main waterfall. It's about another 1 mile. We'll be right back. In a way, we have so many waterfalls. This is not main one, but it's like probably the right by the last one. It's so nice here, guys. So beautiful. Now you guys see almost right there. It's very steep hike on the end, but will be paid off. I can feel it. I can feel the breeze of the water. It's a huge waterfall.
Virginia Falls is another multi-tier waterfall with the main fall drop in roughly about 50 feet.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, look at this.
Feels like time is going faster than it seems. We were just two kids who were trying to live the teenage dream. We could see no reason, but we should ever try to go to sleep. Remember every weekend, we stayed out late and then went home late. I wish that I could live that dream again. Cause it was only you and me back then.
Now we are coming back to our van. We actually called her Annabella, if nobody knows. We can wear this van this year. I did all by myself. And we've got this beautiful vehicle we use as a home. Let's say a second home to travel.
The Sun Road is the most scenic landmark crossing Glacier National Park between the west entrance near the Community West Glacier and east entrance of St. Mary. We got very lucky because this road usually opens up mid of July and closing end of September. We get to this location almost end of September, and we got really lucky to drove those road about 3 times. This is a 50 miles paved road. It was completed in 1930s and in 1983 was designated as a National Civil Engineering Landmark in place of the National Register of Historical Places in the United States.
Said we'd be young forever. You taught me how to love, and nothing could be better than you and me, baby. It was you and me. We could never fall, but nobody could break us. Yeah, I thought we had it all. Take me back to when it was you and me, baby. It was you and me.
Guys, we're approaching Logan Pass.
Birthday, and one of my friends wished me that I should come up and make most out of my life, and that all my most radical desire come true. So we decided to hike under the rain. I think it's one of my craziest desires.
Radical so, desires.
Radical. It's. I have to think what other radical desires I have, but this is one to hike under the rain. Let's do it.
It's the highest elevation.
Yes.
In Glacier National Park, it's 6,646 feet. So we decided to do it, 3 miles long. Let's do it.
Yeah, I'll show you guys where we're going to go. I think you can see it from here. It's a beautiful place. Right, let's go. She's catching up the breath.
Yeah, I try to catch up my breath climbing the stairs up to this path. It's unbelievable. It's 2 o'clock afternoon and feels like it's 6:30 p.m. So dark and cold.
Oh
can see a lot of flowers here. Bears eat some berries, some flowers too. And in summertime, it's covered with beautiful flowers and very, very short season, only about 3 months in this meadow. Those mountains get closer and closer and closer. They're so huge. I hope we're not gonna see any grizzly bears today. Yesterday they closed this hike. We stopped by here yesterday, but they closed hike for a couple hours because grizzly bears was right on the trail. Here is the lake. Wow.
I expected more.
We got lake. Wow, here's the lake. It's one of the lake, you can see it from here.
Maybe we should go over there. Maybe there will be better view of the lake.
Let's go see it.
Let's do it.
At least no raining right now, so
it's a little bit rainy.
Work here.
But not much. We love it here.
Oh no, another surprise, danger. Close to the trail, all travelers. Warning, bear frequency area, hiking lake, trail closed. Many grizzly bears in the area right now, and they're huge. And before hibernation, they have to eat a lot, and we definitely doesn't want to be a snack for them. They're gonna go to sleep very soon. And we've been yesterday in our campground, and people told us probably within 1 week snow is not going, and snow can cover over 10 feet. It's crazy. But weather in mountains can change very, very rapidly. And you have to be prepared to anything, even to see the grizzly bears. Okay, I guess we have to turn around and go back. Look at this guy's amazing view.
When you see it, you want to leave, and that's why we work, and so that we can take these wonderful vacations to enjoy nature, national parks, breathe fresh air, see wonderful views.
Right now approaching to Lake McDonald Lodge. We're staying tonight for Ina's birthday, and I'm first time here. It's one of the oldest one in this area. Can see those buses. This is buses, like prehistorical buses in Glacier National Park. They arrive right to the Lake McDonald's Lodge right here, and this is lodge where we're staying today, and it's nice and beautiful right on the lake, and we'll show you lake just a little bit later. Here's my love.
Hi. We're in historical place, McDonald's Lodge. It was built in 1913 and by one gentleman who lived just across of creek. And it's always been hotel since 1913. It's when Glacier already was popular, and it's not the first hotel that was built in Glacier National Park. We just explore, enjoy it here, see those tourist buses that are unique to Glacier National Park. They are so amazing.
It's a beautiful lake. Glacier National Park, one of my favorite national parks, but unfortunately, we got to go. But we will definitely come back here again.